Hello, we are
Frank,
Lori,
Andy,
Tyler
from the English department.
Today, we are here to present our English project report upon the topic, Does napping help improve undergraduate students' cognitive functioning in foreign university? An investigation between College of Foreign Languages versus College of Science and Engineering. So let's get started. This is the outline. I'm giving the introduction. Tyler, Frank will deal with the data and our hypothesis. Finally, Zoe is in charge of the discussion and conclusion. Before entering this topic, we should clarify some of the terms. Sleep deprivation, which refers to getting less than the needed amount of sleep, which for adults ranges from 7 to 9 hours of sleep a night. Next, napping is widely categorized, and we mainly focus on recovery nap, which is taken to compensate the loss of sleep caused by sleep deprivation. So why would we choose this topic? Because we found that sleep deprivation is a common problem. In Taiwan, the research shows that up to 90% of junior and senior high school students experienced sleep deprivation. We want to find out among the undergraduate students of CFL and CSE in FJU, first, whether sleep deprivation can cause negative influences on cognitive function and mental status. And second, whether napping is effective under various conditions. So we developed 4 research questions. If you want to take a closer look, you can pause for a second. Basically, the first 2 is about sleep deprivation's influence on one's cognitive functioning and mental health. The other 2 are about the academic performance, duration of napping, influence on the effective of napping. And we decided to approach our topic with online questionnaire and with secondary sources from journals, news, etc. As for the details of the questionnaire, we break down the questionnaire in 5 parts. Again, the questionnaire are so detailed, so you can pause the video for a closer look. Eventually, our study indicates that sleep deprivation does influence negatively on cognitive functioning and mental health. And generally speaking, napping can help improve these 2 aspects. But the effectiveness will vary according to the duration of napping and, surprisingly, the academic performance of respondents. In the end, we suggest that people fulfill the total sleep time of 7 and aid it with a 5-minute nap to avoid sleep deprivation. So, before going into analysis of data and hypothesis, please let me kindly give an overview of our data. Our questionnaire received 197 effective responses with 114 from CSE and 83 from CFL. So now let's move on to the next part.
Hello, my name is Tyler. I'll be carrying on the presentation. Here's our first research question and research hypothesis. In order to answer this research question, we asked a few questions. One question we saw, we found that most people agree and strongly agree that they have longer reaction time when having sufficient sleep. The result is correlated with the academic source that we found. One of the sources did an experiment where participants undergone 2 nights of minimum sleep. Later, they found that their duration and frequency to respond increased. Furthermore, their reaction time doubled and their lapse of attention increased 5-fold. From another questionnaire result, most people agree and strongly agree that they going to be forgetful when having insufficient sleep. This result also correlated with the source that we found. Those that don't get enough sleep would damage their part of brain that is responsible for memories, which is the posterior hippocampus. And I saw the questionnaire, most people agree and strongly agree that they can't concentrate when having insufficient sleep. This finding also correlated with the same source we found, that when people did not get enough sleep, their performances are the same as those that have 0.10% of blood alcohol concentration, and that is the level that meet or exceed the legal limits for driving while intoxicated in all US states. Overall, our hypothesis is correlated with the questionnaire result and secondhand data result. Now moving on to the second research question and research hypothesis. In order to answer this research question, again, we asked a few questions. The result of the question, as we see that most people are strongly agree and agree that they feel fatigue when having sufficient sleep. This result linked to the secondhand source that we found, those that have inadequate sleep will damage their cognitive processes and their internal state, such as long-term goal and short-term goal, which can result in low level of motivation. Another question we asked, the result of the question was that most people are neutral and agree with feeling emotional, quick-tempered, depressed when having insufficient sleep. The result is somewhat correlated with the source that we found. It has been stated that the lack of safety grade 1 mood causes stress and frustration, which can lead to aggressive behavior. Overall, a hypothesis of this question is the same as the questionnaire result and the second data.
Hello everyone, I'm Frank. Next, I will talk about research question number 3 and number 4. For the third question, we want to know whether academic performance will influence the effectiveness of napping when university students have insufficient sleep. We assume that those who with good performance will have a more effective napping than those who with poor performance. So we ask our respondents these two questions to find the evidence. First, we ask them what is their academic performance. Second, we ask them if they agree with the statement, taking a proper nap is helpful to improve mental status and cognitive functioning when having insufficient sleep. Here are the pie charts showing our result. After we analyzed the data, we found the correlation coefficient is quite high. For the first question, we want to know whether the effectiveness will differ according to the duration of napping they take. We assume that napping will be effective if it's less than 15 minutes. And in our questionnaire, we ask them, how long do you think is the most proper time for a nap when having insufficient sleep? And we ask them, taking a proper nap is effective for improving the mental status and cognitive function when having insufficient sleep. And the result shows that if the respondents have more than 15 minutes nap, they will have a better mental status and cognitive functions.
I'm Lloyd. From the first-hand data we collected from the questionnaire and secondary data from scholar journals, we believe that sleep deprivation is an important issue for college students because almost a half of our respondents reveals that they sleep less than 6 hours every day. Students who lack of sleep are prone to get depression and negative feelings. Also, they are at a high risk of getting disease. Apart from health problems, sleep deprivation makes students hard to pay for concentration and memorize things. Since sleep is so important for college students to achieve not only better academic performance but also cognitive function, they should be aware of this problem. In order to solve a lacking of sleep, we provide some solutions from the experts. National Sleep Foundation in the US suggests that for young adults, the age of 18 to 25, they should sleep at least 7 hours to 9 hours. Moreover, taking a nap about 15 minutes can help improve one's cognitive function and mental health. Thus, total sleep time and napping are main factors that influence college students' cognitive function and mental health. As a conclusion, sleep deprivation influences not only people's cognitive function but also mental health negatively. Without sufficient sleep, students often feel fatigued, react slowly, be forgetful, cannot concentrate, and even lose motivation to reach their goals. Not only our first-hand data, but also other research showed the correlation of total sleeping hours and academic performance. As a result, napping is beneficial for college students who suffer from sleep deprivation, and our research provides a suggestion for college students who want to have better academic performance or suffer from sleep deprivation. After listening to our presentation, if you do not get enough sleep today, you can take a nap during break time. Thank you for listening and hope you sleep enough every day.